بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمد الله ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد. First of all, I would like to say Jazakallah to Sheikh Tariq Masi for taking out special time for us and coming all the way to this message. MashaAllah, it's a moment of honor and Jazakallah khair. Brother Tariq will be our leader and he will be guiding us step by step when we will reach Medina, inshallah. And if you have any questions regarding where we'll be staying and the hotel's management and all the good stuff, we can always talk to or ask questions after, inshallah, after the session. Alhamdulillah, I think we did in detail the virtue of the fada'il of Hajj. We've been doing it for the last 3-4 weeks to encourage ourselves to go out for Hajj. And Alhamdulillah, we did last Friday also the virtues of the Hajj. I will just go over one hadith of the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just to remind ourselves that how great this blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. Al-Bukhari, Imam Al-Bukhari, Imam Muslim, rahimahum Allah, they both narrated this hadith by Abi Huraira radiallahu anhu. That the Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that من حج فلم يرفس ولم يفسق رجع كيوم ولدته. That whoever performs Hajj without involving in major or minor sins, or sins that will lead him to sexual desires, if he restricts himself from all these sins, all these major and minor sins, to the best of his ability, رَجَعَ كَيَوْمٍ وَلَدَتْ أُمُّهُ, then he will return from Hajj like the day his mother gave birth to him. He will be pure from all his sins. He will be pure from all his sins. So it's a great opportunity and it's a great bounty and the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we will be visiting the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's a great gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He had blessed with this opportunity. And we need to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this visit as a, you know, as an acceptance visit and give us tawfiq to visit Him subhanahu wa ta'ala again and again. Again and again, inshaAllah. Let this Hajj be our first Hajj and starting point. And inshaAllah, later on we make intention, oh Allah, we'll come to your house again, we'll come to your house again till we leave this earth. And also Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, al-umratu ila al-umratu kafaratu lima baynahuma wal-hajj al-mabrur laysa lahu jazaa'un illa al-jannah. Then a umrah to the next umrah is a kafara for the sin a person commits in between. وَالْحَجُّ الْمَبْرُورُ لَيْسَ لَهُ جَزَاءٌ إِلَّا الْجَنَّةِ. And to perform Hajj Mabrur has no reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala but confirm Jannah. But confirm Jannah. And here we have to keep in our mind that what is Hajj Mabrur? You know, we perform Hajj. Performing Hajj is different than performing Hajj Mabrur. Hajj Mabrur, muhaddiseen rahimahumullah have given the meaning of Hajj Mabrur is to perform Hajj in a way in which you restrict yourself from all that is evil, from all that is nonsense and worthless. Because, alhamdulillah, brother Tariq Masi could get this also, when we go out for Hajj, we will see people involving in everything but the main maqsad that we were there, or we will be there. People will be, mashallah, unfortunately, backbiting of one another. People will be having different talks, especially about the politicians, that what needs to be done, or what is going on in the politics of Pakistan, and politics of Egypt, and politics of all over the world. Everything will be discussed, especially at the time of Arafah, Mina, you know, at the time of Mina, Arafah, and Muzdalifah. To the extent that ulama have said that they have seen people witnessing or people playing cards just to kill the great time. You know, just to kill the time. So we have to ask ourselves that what is Hajj, or what kind of a Hajj do we need to perform? Do we need to perform a Hajj in which we force our body and ourselves to be in Mecca and Medina? Or we need to perform Hajj that is Hajj Mabrur. That is in a way in which we restrict ourselves from all that is nonsense and that all that is worthless in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in Quran and Sunnah. And also we need to make sure before we go out for Hajj or before even we buy the package, that what is the intention or what intention should we have when we are going out for Hajj? Because making the right intention is the foundation of every amal. If we have the wrong intention, that you know, to increase our Hajj, you know, Hajj time or Hajj status, mashallah, I have performed Hajj 3 times, 4 times, 10 times, or it is to visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So renew your intention. I myself will renew my intention that, oh Allah, it is for only and only your sake, and it is only and only to get your pleasure. I do not want to get the Hajj title with my name for the rest of my life, or I do not want to brag in front of people that I have performed 3, 4, 5, 10 Hajj. This Hajj that, oh Allah, I'm going out for, it is only and only to please you and to get the Jannah, inshaAllah, on the day of Qiyamah. Abdullah ibn Mubarak, rahimahullah, was a great tabi'i, was the student of many Sahaba. He was a great abid also, great mujahid and great zahid. The Mu'allifin have written a beautiful story regarding his intention or regarding the Hajj. Abdullah ibn Mubarak, rahimahullah, used to go out for Hajj 1 year, and the next year he would go out for jihad in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So for many years he did that. He would go out for Hajj 1 year and he would go out for jihad 1 year. But one time when he went to Hajj, he came back from Hajj and he saw in his dream that there were malaika talking to one another and saying to them that this year Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rejected everybody's Hajj. This is in the time of Abdullah ibn Mubarak, rahimahullah. It was one of the best times in the era, in the history of Islam also. So it made him really wonder that why everyone's Hajj is rejected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He made tawbah, cried Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but later on he saw in his dream again the same two malaika talking to one another. One was telling the other that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted the Hajj of everyone who visited his house, who came for Hajj, because of one person. And this person, he did not even make it to Hajj. Ali ibn Mufid, rahimahullah, was a shoemaker. Was one of the righteous men of that time who used to make shoes. And that year he made full intention that, oh Allah, I will go out to perform Hajj. But before he was going, or before he left out for Hajj, he saw in his dream, he saw his neighbors, Ali ibn Mufid, rahimahullah, he saw his neighbors that they were really struggling with their life. They were really poor. They were not making their life, you know, as happy and safe and sound. So what he did, he gave all his earnings to them. He gave all his earnings to these poor people, and he said, oh Allah, I will do it for this, inshallah. So the malaika were talking in the dream of Abdullah ibn Mubarak, rahimahullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted the Hajj of everyone because of this sincere intention, because of the mukhlis intention of one person, Ali ibn Mufid, rahimahullah. So we need, it's the basic, it's the foundation of our Hajj, that we need to make sure that when we are leaving our house, we will be sacrificing many things. Some of us, mashallah, will have the jobs closed, will be, you know, losing some money, when they will not be able to make it, or while they were not going to their work. We will be making many sacrifices for Hajj. But if our intention is wrong, all the good that we do will be received by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us renew our intention. That, oh Allah, for this Hajj that we are going this year, it is only and only for your sake. It is only and only to please you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We do not want to get any worldly benefit out of this Hajj, or we do not want to get any name and fame or any piety title with our names, inshallah. These are the few things, if we keep in our mind, inshallah, it will be beneficial for us, for Hajj, inshallah. And we make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept the Hajj of everyone who makes it to Hajj, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant everyone tawfiq who are back home. If not make it this year, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them tawfiq that they make it next year as soon as possible, inshallah. Now I will go, inshallah, over some of the the three tests we can keep in our mind when we go out for Hajj. Number one is to make sure that if we have any debt that we have to pay off to people, not the debt of the house or the car loans, that you owe someone and it is payable, then pay it to people, inshallah, before you go out for Hajj. Because in Hajj, it's really amazing that we will see many janazas after every salah. I'm not trying to scare anyone off, but we will see many janazas after every salat in Masjid al-Haram and Masjid al-Nabawi. They will be called mad that salat and janazas taking place. People in very good health, in very good health, when they go out for Hajj, they get sick. Imagine, there will be 300 to 400, or shekel, correct me, maybe 5 million people will be doing the same ritual, same ibadat, at the same place. So there are high chances. This is the behavior. This was the behavior of our Salaf also. In fact, I remember that in Pakistan, in India also, when people would go out for Hajj, they would go visit everyone of their family members, everyone in their community, and would ask them for an apology. They would go out, ask them for an apology, that please forgive me for whatever the issue was. So it is really good. It is really good that you ask for an apology from all your friends, from all your family members. And I myself would like to ask for an apology from all the brothers who are present in here. That please forgive me if I have done anything wrong to you. Or I know I have done any wrongs to you. Please forgive me from the depth of your heart. Because in one hadith, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clearly stated that when the a'mal of the people are presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on every Mondays and every Thursdays, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the a'mal, except the a'mal of the person or a'mal of those people who had fight with one another. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept the a'mal, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell the malaika, let them resolve the issues. So if you have any issues with anyone, especially with your parents, or with your children, or with your family members, with your spouses, please clean your heart before you go out for Hajj. You go out for Hajj, inshallah. We make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He keep us safe and sound in Hajj, but this is Hajj, inshallah. The second thing we need to keep in our mind, is that when we go out for Hajj, we need to make sure that all the medication that we take daily, we take with us, inshallah. And like the daily use medication, especially the Tylenol, ibuprofen, and maybe a couple of packs of antibiotic, amoxicillin or stuff like that, inshallah, it will be really helpful. However, we can find clinics at the time of Hajj, but it will be difficult, inshallah. I encourage the brothers, everyone, to take few daily use tablets, inshallah. It will be beneficial for you at the time of Hajj, inshallah. And also, don't forget to take vaseline with you. Vaseline is really important, because when you wear ihram, we will not be able to wear undergarments. So, and we have to walk a lot. And at the time of Jamarat, sometimes we forget the waist, we forget our tents. So instead of walking 1 hour, you might end up walking for 2 hours or 3 hours. So get ready for that, inshallah. Take plenty of vesting, inshallah, with you. It will be really beneficial for you. And also, I encourage myself and everyone to take light clothing with you. Light clothing with you, like light jubbas and plastic shoes. And especially with the shoes, take them like you were going to lose them. Because it's very easy at the time of Hajj to lose your shoes, inshallah. And also for Medina, the weather of the Medina is really amazing weather. It's hot during the day, and sometimes at night it gets cold. So if you want, you can take a very light jacket, just to be on the safe side, if you're really used to the warm weather, inshallah. Take a light jacket in Medina, for Medina. For Mecca, inshallah, we will not need. And then also take the ihram belt if you want to buy from here. You can have to buy the ihram belt from Mecca. And also take a small cash. Don't get a lot of money with you. Anything will happen at time of Hajj. People lose their valuable things. And also for emergency, take one credit card and one debit card, inshallah. It will be beneficial for just for emergencies, inshallah. And also use or take unfragranced hand sanitizer, inshallah, because you will be touching a lot of stuff there at the time of Hajj. You can use it while you are at the time of Arafat, Mina, and Muzdalifah, inshallah. It will be helpful, inshallah. And also I have brought this bag with me. This bag, we use it at the time of Tawaf, or at the time when you go out to in Haram, inside the Haram. However, you will be provided, sometimes they give shopping bags at the door to keep your shoes in. But I use this bag, I put my shoes inside there, and then I put it in my bag. That way you will not lose your shoes, inshallah. I'll tell you really expensive shoes, inshallah. But however you might lose it. Also for Arafat, for Mina and Muzdalifah, if you're really used to using toilet paper, take some toilet paper with you also, inshallah. And also, some of the brothers, mashallah, are very, they're used to very luxury. In Muzdalifah, we will be sleeping in open ground. Everyone will be sleeping in open ground. So, I'm not confirmed with Brother Tariq Masjid, Sheikh will be getting sleeping bags. Inshallah. So it's good, it's very good news. We will be getting sleeping bags, inshallah. So, but if you are really used to very luxury, you can however take those, the yoga mat that's in Academy or in Walmart. It's flat, it's not really uncomfortable. And then you can put your sleeping bag on top of it, inshallah. In just one, for one night in Muzdalifah. However, in Mina and in Arafat, we will have upgraded tents, in which there will be a sofa bed, and we will not need that, inshallah. But for, if you really want to have a good time in Muzdalifah, you really want a comfort sleep, take a yoga mat from Academy, from Mina, inshallah. For all the people, I've seen that they have, because at the time of Jamarat, we have to do a lot of walking. And while we are walking, sometimes we have to stop because of the traffic of people. So for elders, if they can buy one of those, 3 pound, 4 pound chair, when we stop, they put the chair and they could sit on it. So the very lightweight chair. While they are walking, you can carry on with you. And I've seen some people carry, make those light chair as their backpack. They hang it on their back, and then while we are walking, but when we stop, they put their chairs quickly, take a little rest, inshallah. If you want to get that also with you, it might be beneficial for you, inshallah. But however, try to stay as light as you can. As light as you can. You don't have to take two full luggage for Hajj. try to stay as light as you can, inshallah. Take minimum step, the step that you will really need it for necessary. And also try to buy a cheap phone, because many times people lose their expensive phones at the time of Mina or Arafah, Muzdalifah, or maybe in Haram, you know, somebody might take your phone away. So try to buy a cheap phone, you know, $10, $20, $15 phone. Make sure it's unlocked. And we have Brother Abbas here, mashallah, his brother has a beautiful shop also. You can contact him if you want to buy a good phone, inshallah, a phone that could work. And you will not feel any pain if you lose it, inshallah. One other thing that is really important when we are performing Hajj, throughout the Hajj, make sure we will have, mashallah, Mufti Makki with us. I myself will be there, Brother Tariq will be there also. And we have another Sheikh with us from Dallas, will be there with us also. Try to make sure that when you ask Masai, ask from one guy, from one person. Because in Hajj, you will see everyone asking questions from everyone. Everyone who sees or who has beautiful beard on his face, we think he's a alim, he's Sheikh, we ask him questions. And those people, mashallah, are really generous. They give Masai on the spot. So sometimes it leads to many confusion. Make sure you ask one person. Sheikh Musa will be there, inshallah. You can ask him, you can ask myself, that if you are confused about something, ask one person, inshallah. Otherwise, because Hajj as an ibadah, as a ritual, there are some differences of opinion of Imam, Imam Shafi, Imam Malik, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah. There might be a little ikhtilaf in minor things, but just to be on the safe side, ask one person for your issues that might come in your way, inshallah. Also, it's a highly advice, I encourage myself also for it, that don't be a tourist and photographer when you are visiting the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or when you're visiting the house of Nabi al-Masjid al-Nabawi. Because mashallah, mashallah, we will see people, the first thing that they do, as soon as they see Kaaba, we will take the selfie quickly with the Kaaba and then upload it on Facebook or on Twitter right away. MashaAllah, you know, I am visiting the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or look at me, I'm so blessed. Remember, wallahi, I take a surah, I myself, you know, it's my weakness. That no matter how muttaqi and how righteous you are, if camera comes in front of you, it might lessen your sincerity of the specific ibadah. When you're taking picture with the Rawda or with the Kaaba, then the sincerity, you know, is effective. So don't be a tourist or photographer, inshallah. If you really want to take a good photo, if you really want to have your photo with the Kaaba, you can have your Photoshop. There's so many apps these days. That you can put the Kaaba behind and put yourself with it, that would be okay, inshallah. But don't be a tourist. Sometimes, you know, you take pictures and you become so distracted by these pictures after you upload them on Facebook that you're making a tawaf and you're constantly looking and on your phone at how many likes, how many dislikes, and how many comments you have. So you're making a tawaf with your body of Kaaba, but you're really making tawaf of Facebook with your soul. So try not to be a tourist or a photographer while visiting the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all these good places. And also it is really important that make sure before we leave, make two copies of your ticket and passport, leave one behind back home, we'll take one with you, just for in case. Because many times people lose their passport, people lose their values, and then you will not have any backup. So make sure before you leave, make a good copy of your passport and a good copy of your ticket, leave it back home. So just for in case, if we lose them, we can call somebody, you know, our brothers, our parents. If we have lost, please send us back through email, through WhatsApp, whatever we use, inshallah. So make sure you take two copies of your passport and your ticket with you. Keep one with you, keep one back home, inshallah, for the future of us, inshallah. Last, I will mention one thing, inshallah, and that is really the foundation of Hajj. And this thing that I will about to mention, we need it a lot. We will be needing on every step of Hajj. Or I should say that right when we leave our house, we will be needing this thing a lot. And that is sabr, patience. Because remember, when we leave our house, things might not go according to our way or according to our plan, but just don't lose your patience. Sometimes people perform, you know, ibadat, you know, in Arafat and in Muzdalifah, but right after that they start backbiting of people. And remember, when you do backbiting, it's clearly stated in the hadith that when you do backbiting of someone, you indirectly giving them your accepted good deeds. So when you backbite someone, let it go, you know, let go of everyone's mistake, of each other's mistake. Let go of each other's mistake, inshallah. Forgive and forget, as the Tabligha Jama'ah I've heard from them many times, that they say that the character of a Muslim should be forgive and forget. Be patient, inshallah. Because sometimes you will find people there, inshallah, also, or unfortunately, that throughout their hajj, or rather before they even leave the house, they start complaining. That, you know, we were told this and this happened, and we were told that and this happened, and now this and this and this, and a lot of complaints, and we are completely distracted from the main focus that was that we were going out for Hajj to visit the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whatever goes wrong in Hajj, just keep patient, inshallah. Be sabr, be humble, inshallah, and try to help one another, inshallah. Don't be a selfish Hajj. Don't just look after yourself in a most luxurious way and turn your face away from the people. You will see people, mashallah, on the mountains of Mina and Arafah, you know, they will have no tents, no nothing. But they will pray, you know, praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with more sincerity than all of us combined. So make sure when we are, especially at the time of Mina, Arafat and Muzdalifah, keep your nerves together, inshallah. Don't let shaitan take over your soul and make you utter stuff that harms your Hajj, that makes your Hajj weak. And because it's a trick of shaitan, as ulama have clearly stated, that the shaitan, the way it tricks us is that it will not make us do a good deed. It will not make us to perform Hajj. But finally, when we make full intention that, oh Allah, we are going for Hajj, we will be going for Hajj, no matter what comes in our way, we will go out for Hajj, what shaitan will do, it will correct our intention in between. Now it will make us involved in things that are completely unnecessary and completely nonsense. And also shaitan attack us at the end of the ibadah. Sometimes you will see, mashallah, people coming back from Hajj and then telling every single person that, you know what, I am bold, but do you know where I was for the next or past 2 weeks? I was at Hajj. I had the great experience of Hajj. Telling everybody. Rather, our ibadah, As-Samarqandi rahimahullah, Abu Layth As-Samarqandi rahimahullah, says beautifully in his book, is that we need to hide our good deeds as we hide our evil deeds. Because when the riya comes in our good deeds, it makes the good deed go wasted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So while we are performing Hajj, we have to have sincere intention. Or before we go out for Hajj, we have to make sincere intention, middle at the end also. And we come for Hajj, people ask us, then we tell them, you know, alhamdulillah, we were blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to go out for Hajj. If not, inshallah, don't tell people, inshallah. Do not brag about this amal. By bragging about you know, your good deeds, it will be wasted, the riyad comes in. So, also I will have, you know, I have written down all these things. If you want to take a list or hard copy, I will be able to give you after salah, inshallah. Now I would like to ask Mufti Shibli to come and help us in detail that what kind of a Hajj we will be performing and the steps by step Hajj where we'll be going first and then Mina and Arafat and Muzdalifah, inshallah, Muftishibli will be explaining all the religious aspects of Hajj. JazakAllah.